What's going on, guys? Welcome to Everything Always. My name is Michael Roman. Now, as we broke and reported here at the channel over 2 weeks ago, Marvel Studios is back on set and filming for Shang-Chi and the Legend of the Ten Rings, which led to this most recent leak directly from the set, and it came from someone who was willing to post their badge ID number. Now, while that person is probably going to get in trouble even though they've deleted their post, the internet never forgets. They shared a ton of exclusive details about the film, some that fell right in line with a plot leak that we got from 4chan earlier in the year. And even though that plot leak has been deleted in almost every place it was, again, the internet never forgets, and we've got the blue post from that full 4chan deleted plot leak. We're going to read through it word for word, but also share the brand new exclusive details, see how they line up with one another to introduce two brand new villains, including Marvel's first dragon. Like I said, we're going to break it all down and issue the normal spoiler warning, but first, if you could grab the subscribe button, we're giving away two PlayStation 4 Pros, as well as a whole slew of other Marvel-related stuff, including this insane 1/4 scale XM Studios Beta Ray Bill, as well as our third and final Infinity Saga box set. If you want to be entered to win, all you have to do, hit the subscribe button, then hit the notification bell, leave a like and a comment on this video. If you want, stick around at the end of the video. We'll get into all the giveaway stuff again there. So first up, the normal spoiler warning. Usually we tell you to take anything that doesn't come directly from Marvel Studios with a grain of salt, and we will be covering an anonymous 4chan plot leak during this video at some point. That spoiler warning applies to that for sure. However, some of these leaks are coming from someone again who's back on set filming for Shang-Chi, one of the extras, and was able to post their actual ID badge number to the internet. Although they deleted it, again, they're going to get traced. They're probably going to get kicked off the production, but either way, it's verified as details for what's included with this movie. Now, the two biggest details and revealed were obviously the inclusion of the villains, one of which was none other than Baron Mordo. And we've talked about this, how his crossover from the Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness will work in conjunction with Shang-Chi and the Legend of the Ten Rings. And there's even a possibility that the Shang-Chi and the Legend of the Ten Rings could be a prequel set sometime between when we saw Doctor Strange and the eventual conclusion to the Infinity Saga. Now, the second and even crazier villain named was none other than Marvel's cosmic dragon, Fin Fang Foom, for which there are some Infinity Saga Easter eggs, mostly which take place during Iron Man 3. Now, either way, this ties directly again to this anonymous 4chan plot leak, which was posted and predated all of the confirmed information we've had about Shang-Chi in the Legend of the Ten Rings, and since then has been considered to be probably the most realistic. It was deleted in every place it was online. However, again, the internet will never let you forget anything, and there are ways to get deleted Reddit posts, which is what we have right here. Now, we're going to go ahead and read through this thing word for word, and again, spoiler warning, if you want to come in fresh to Shang-Chi, then you might want to back out now, as a lot of this has been corroborated from one source or another from when it was first posted. I know some leaked Shang-Chi plot details. I was going to post them on a Marvel forum, but people said that this is the place for MCU related leaks, that being Marvel Studios spoilers. I made it a Reddit account for this, and I don't know if it's against the rules, but I'm just trying to relay some information about the movie that I've been hearing. I don't know if I need a badge of proof or what is the protocol here, so I'm hoping I'm not doing anything wrong. Basically, an alien spacecraft landed in China hundreds of years ago. The spacecraft was powered by 10 rings, magical relics that all served different purposes. The rings were looted by a secret society known as the Avatars, which led to a wise martial artist simply named the Ancestor. The Ancestor wore the rings and used them to become an expert fighter. The Mandarin grew up hearing about the Ancestor's story and was fascinated by it, despite everyone else believing it was just a myth. He began to idolize the Ancestor and devoted his life to finding the rings. This inspired him to form his own mafia, which is the Ten Rings Gang. Basically, the point of the gang is to look for all of the rings around the world. He adopts his niece, Fa Lu Su, played by Awkwafina, and teaches her martial arts. After years of investigation, he discovers that the Legend of the Ten Rings is indeed real and that the Ancestor is dying. There was a leak a little while back that said Shang-Chi is a tournament film, and that's actually true. When the Ancestor dies, the Avatars will run a secret tournament Kung Fu trial in which the winner will be granted the Ten Rings. The Mandarin is too old to compete, but he doesn't want to risk Fa Lu Su's life, and there is where Shang-Chi comes in. Shang is a street urchin who meets the Mandarin after he begins dating Fa. The Mandarin takes a liking to Shang and starts training him as his apprentice. At first, his task as the gang initiation is to kill Trevor for impersonating the Mandarin. People speculated that they would be related, but it's more of a Walter White, Jesse Pinkman dynamic. When the tournament begins, the Mandarin will send Shang to win and get the rings for him. That'll be the basic gist of the film, pretty much. I know that defeating Fin Fang Foom will be an obstacle. Liga Wu and Clive Reston will be in the movie as S.H.I.E.L.D. agents who are investigating the Ten Rings gang. Shang-Chi will obviously betray the Mandarin and become a hero over the course of the film. He will get the ability to create multiple duplicates of himself. Now, this, quick side note, was a power from a more modern run, but pretty awesome at that. It'll be a, quote, Orphan Black situation where each clone of himself has their own personality. So the fight scenes will obviously be insane to witness. Marvel is casting Shang's enemy in the tournament. One of them will be a character named Kao. Now, what's awesome about this plot leak, and what I always say about all these 4chan plot leaks, is it's really easy to write one of these after you've gotten a ton of details about the film, and then you just fill in the blanks with fan fiction. This actually predated all of the leaks of the castings for this tournament and all of the enemies and villains in Shang-Chi. Some weeks or months after this 4chan post is when we started getting industry insiders and all the Hollywood trades talking about the casting for that tournament. And of course, everything basically got put on hold in the earlier part of this year as we went into these full delays, and it quelled all of these rumors and speculation. But the truth is that we now have multiple sources with some validity. Remember, the guy who posted the comments today actually posted his badge number, and then this plot leak was corroborated later by several industry insider sources talking about all of the villains that were being cast for this film and the possibility of it being a tournament film. It seems like a lot of sources have at least some of the same details, including Baron Mordo and Fin Fang Foom. Of course, Baron Mordo hanging over from the original Doctor Strange trilogy, it would make sense that he would show up in this film as well. And even though there is some speculation that he'll be connected to Fin Fang Foom, that's pretty irrelevant considering you don't need to tie those two elements together. They fit into the narrative independently of each other without that need. Either way, if they're including the 10 Power Rings, Fin Fang Foom, Baron Mordo, and all these other elements in the very first Shang-Chi film, this is sizing up to be an absolute smash of a blockbuster, and this is one of the films that I'm most excited for in Marvel Phase 4. I get asked that all the time, and this is looking like one of the most fresh outings, something we haven't seen before. Well, and of course, if we get Marvel's first dragon, then it'll indeed be just that. Guys, let me know all your comments down below how hype you are for this film. It's not that far off now. We're literally less than a year away, and considering how long we've waited at this point, well, it's a little while longer. Let me know all your thoughts down in the comments below as well about Fin Fang Foom. Are you familiar with this character, and are you ready for that character amongst the rest of the ensemble in the Marvel Cinematic Universe? I'm all ears, and quickly, let's get into the giveaway stuff before I let you go. We're still giving away two PlayStation 4 Pros, the next of which is at the 700,000 subscriber mark. All you have to do to be entered to win, hit the subscribe button, then hit the notification bell, leave a like and a comment on this video, and that'll automatically enter you to win all the rest of the prizes here at the channel, like this insane 1/4 scale XM Studios Beta Ray Bill. This is in no way an action figure at almost 3 feet, a 30 inches tall. It's an immaculately sculpted museum quality piece, as well as our third and final Infinity Saga box set. We gave two away earlier this year. We'll give this final one away somewhere during the holiday season at the end of the year in December. If you want to be entered to win either of the PlayStations, the Beta Ray Bill, the Infinity Saga box set, or any of the other prizes we give away here at the channel, all the same rules will always apply. Hit the subscribe button, then hit the notification bell, leave a like and a comment on this video, and because it's truly random, the more videos you like and comment on, the better chance you have of winning. All winners will be announced at the end of videos, the same way we're doing here. And if you've missed any of those previous winner announcements, no worries. All you have to do is scroll back through the channel, look for the winner announcement in the sub count, in the title, click on that video, and scroll to the end. My name's Michael Roman. This is Everything Always, guys. Thanks so much for checking the channel, and stick around. We'll be posting again real soon.